Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So we are discussing our lesson, that is what? Crop production and management. Up till now we have discussed the different agriculture practices. So today we will move for the next agriculture practice, that is nothing but what? Harvesting. Okay, so the harvesting is the last, or we can say the second last agriculture practice which we are doing after the maturation of the crops. Okay, so after becoming all these agriculture practices, within 3 to 4 months the crops become ready to cut. Okay, and that cutting of the crops is nothing but called as what? Harvesting. Okay, so let's see what is the definition for the harvesting. The process of cutting and gathering of crop after its maturation is called harvesting. Okay, so what is mean by harvesting? The process of cutting, in that we are cutting the crops and we are collecting it together, or we are gathering it. Okay, process of cutting and gathering of crops after its maturation. Whenever the crops are getting mature, we are cutting them and we are gathering them togetherly, and it is only called as what? Harvesting. Okay, so basically in our country this harvesting can be done manually. Okay, so this harvesting can be done manually by using a sickle. Okay, so in the image you can see the sickle, how it is exactly. So sickle is the one type of the agricultural tool which is having C shape. Okay, and with the help of that farmers can cut the crops. Okay, so the harvesting is what? The cutting of the crops. The farmers sometimes, what happen, they are pulling the crops or they are cutting the crops to the ground by using this sickle. Okay, so this harvesting can be done manually by using the sickle, or also it can be done by using certain machines which is called as what? Harvester. Okay, so it can be done manually by sickle and can be done by using a machine which is called as what? Harvester. Next one, after the crop is harvested, the grains are separated from the chaff by a process called threshing. Okay, so after harvesting there is a next step. Okay, after harvesting there is a next step the farmers has to perform, that is nothing but what? Threshing. Okay, so in the threshing what happened? Threshing means what? Whatever the chaff or whatever the rubbish, unwanted food things, materials which are present in the crop, that we have to remove, and that is only called as what? Threshing. Okay, so after the crop is harvested the grains are separated from the chaff by the process called threshing. Okay, so from the plants or the from the crops the grains are getting separated. We have to remove or we have to separate the grains from the plant or from the stems of the crops, and that only we are calling as what? Threshing. So this threshing also can be done by the manually, also by striking the bunch of the crops on the land. Okay, by using that we can remove the grains from the chaff. Okay, and also it can be done by using the machine, that is called as what? Thresher is used for threshing. Okay, so it can be done with the help of the thresher also, that is one type of the machine which helps to do the process of threshing. Okay, so it is in a small quantity. If the grains are on a large scale, if your field is on the large scale, then combined machine perform a dual job. Okay, so if the area is so much large, or there is a large area, the crop area is big, then the farmer is using combined machine. Okay, and this combined machine done the dual job. Now dual job means what? This combined machine can do harvesting also, and this combined machine can do threshing also. Okay, means this combined machine is helps to cut the crops, and also it helps to remove the grains from the chaff or separate the grains from the chaff. Okay, so that is only, it is called as what? Combine. Okay, so combinedly or togetherly doing the work, that's why it is called as what? Combine. Okay, so it does the dual job. So after harvesting, threshing, there is one process which is very important to do, that is nothing but what? Winnowing. Okay, and what is mean by winnowing? That you have already seen your previous classes. Okay, in the image also again you can see what is the exactly winnowing is happen. So after threshing the grains are getting separated, but with that there are the certain things are present. Okay, or the seed cover is also present that we have to remove, and that we can do with the help of the winnowing. Okay, so winnowing helps in the separation of the grains from the husk. Okay, why we have to perform the winnowing process? Because the winnowing helps in the separation of the grains from the husk. Okay, and after that we are getting the proper grains. Okay, so this winnowing can be done manually also with the help of like this. You can see in the image how the winnowing can happen manually, and also the winnowing can be done by using the winnowing machine. Again, it is on the, if it is on a large scale, then winnowing machine is used to do the winnowing process. Okay, so this is now what harvesting. So harvesting is not a single method, it is not a single agriculture practices. After harvesting also there are the certain processes that farmers have to perform. What is that? First they have to do harvesting, then there is a threshing, and after that there is what? Winnowing. And after that we are getting the clean grains that we can use or that we can include in our diet. Okay, so harvesting means what we are telling, it is a mature crop. Okay, so after the so much hard work or after doing the so many agriculture practices, within a 5 to 6 months or the farmers can see the mature crops or the golden crops which are standing in the field. Okay, and it makes very joyful, or the farmers are feeling very good whenever they are seeing that standing crops. Okay, so because of that the farmers are celebrating that days. Okay, and that is only we are calling as what? Harvesting festival. And according to the region, the harvesting festivals are very different. They are singing some songs, they are dancing. Why? Because they are feeling very joyful. Finally, they are getting the quality products of their hard work. Okay, so there are the different harvesting festivals are there. We can say that Baisakhi is there, Holi is there. Also, we can say that Pongal is there, and Bihu. All these are the different harvesting festivals which are getting celebrated according to the different regions. Okay, so this is all about harvesting and harvest festival. Okay, and now we will move for the next point, that is nothing but what? Storage. Okay, that is very important, because as you cut the crop, then it is very necessary to store that crops properly, because if we store it properly, then throughout the year we can use that grains. So it is very important to store the crops properly, to use it to get a continue soil or to get the continuous use of that storage crop grains or that store grains. Okay, so whenever the farmers are cutting the crops, okay, that time they are mature, but still they are having certain types of the moisture in them. Okay, and because of that, that crops can get easily affected by the insect, pests, some fungi or other microbes, and which makes them destroyed. Okay, also there are the certain organisms, we can say that rodents are there, rats are there, which are destroying the crops. Okay, or which are destroying the grains. So it is very important to store the grains properly, or to store the yield, whatever we are getting from the crop, it is very important to store it properly. Okay, so before storing the grains, before storing the yield, or before storing the crops, it should be dried properly in the sunlight. Okay, so if it is in a small quantity, then very easily we can store it in a sunlight. But if it is on a commercial basis, then some machines are using to dry the grains. Okay, so the very warm air is blowing on the grains, and in this way they are getting dried. Okay, so before storing the crops, we have to dry it very properly, which helps to protect the crops from the pest, insect or certain types of the organisms. Okay, so it is an important task of the storage. So the storage is an important task. Grains dried in the sun to reduce moisture. Okay, next one is that after doing this drying, the grains are stored in the gunny bags. Okay, so on a small scale, farmers store grains in jute bags or metallic bins. Okay, so if it is in a small quantity or it is in a small scale, then generally the farmers are using the gunny bags or metallic bins. But if it is in a commercial scale, then what happens? The food grains are stored in gunny bags, in granaries or in silos. Okay, so if it is in a commercial basis or the production is in a more amount, then that grains are stored in a gunny bags and they are storing into the granaries or in a silos. Okay, so these silos are the very big cylindrical structures, and in that different atoms are stored at the different levels, and they are having certain space. With the help of that space, we can remove the gunny bags whenever it requires, or we can remove the food atoms whenever it requires. Okay, so on the large scales, granaries or the silos is used, and a small scale, gunny bags or the metallic bins are used for the storage of the grains. Okay, so this is all about what? Harvesting and storage. Okay, now we'll move for the next point. Okay, so let's discuss the next point, that is what? Increasing crop yield. Okay, so as we know, our India is a very vast country. Every day there is the number of population is getting increasing, and it is very important to provide the enough amount of food for their increasing population. Okay, so for that, what we have to do? We have to increase the production of crops also, or we have to increase the crops yield also. So how we can increase the crop yield? For that, the farmers has used the new techniques, or the farmer should involve the different modern techniques while doing the different agriculture practices. Also, we can say that if the agriculture practices which we have discussed, that if all these are done at the regular time and properly in a proper sequence, also we can say that by avoiding the over irrigation or by avoiding the overuse of the fertilizers and the manures, we can increase the proper yield of the crops. Okay, or we can increase the crop yield. Also, we can say that if we'll protect the crops from the pest, and also we can say the different organisms or the diseases and the weeds, then also it is possible to increase the number of yield, or we can take the more amount of the yield from the crops by performing the different agriculture practices, by involving the modern technology. But those who are scientists are giving every day, okay, different techniques are there by using the different machines. Okay, by using all these things, we can increase the crop yield. Okay, also we can say that by using the good variety of the crops, we can increase the yield. Okay, because that good variety of the seeds or the good variety of the crops can give us the more amount of the yield, or the more production of the yield. Also, we can say that the variety of the seeds which is having the disease resistance also and can give the more amount of the yield also, like that seeds we can use to increase the crop yield. Also, the scientists, we can say that the scientists are performing the different experiments. In that one, we can say that seed breeding. Okay, now the seed breeding is means what? With the help of the seed breedings, it is possible to control the reproduction in the plants to get the desired quality of the seed, or to get the proper or the fulfilled quality of the seed. It is possible in the seed breeding. Okay, so in this way, there are these things are there, or if we'll take in all these things in the mind, then it is possible to increase the crop yield. Okay, so just now we have discussed about the seed breeding. Okay, so what is exactly the seed breeding? That only we will discuss in the next point, that is nothing but what? Hybridization. Okay, that we'll discuss in the next one, that is nothing but what? Hybridization. Okay, so let's discuss what is mean by hybridization. Let's discuss the definition. Hybridization is a technique used for developing new varieties of crop by crossbreeding two different varieties. Okay, so what is mean by the hybridization? The hybridization is a technique in that what happened used for developing new varieties. Okay, this hybridization is a technique which is used to develop the new varieties of crops by crossbreeding two different varieties. Okay, means by using the two different variety, we combine the two different varieties and from that combination we can produce the new varieties. Okay, so in this way developing new varieties of crop by cross breeding two different varieties. Okay, so let's see how it exactly happens. One plant is selected as male and the other one is as female. So among that the two varieties are getting selected. One variety is selected as a male and the another plant is selected as a female. Okay, so the one plant is selected as male, that is one variety. Second variety is selected as a female. Okay, next one is that during the bud condition or whenever the bud condition is there, during that period the anther is removed. Okay, so whenever the flower is in the bud condition, the anther gets removed. Why the anther is getting removed or why we have to remove the anther? To prevent self-pollination. Okay, so anther is removed to prevent self-pollination, and the removing of the anther during the bud condition to prevent the self-pollination, that process is called as what? Emasculation. Okay, that process is called as what? Emasculation. So what happens in exactly in the emasculation? It is the process in that the anther is removed to stop or to prevent the self-pollination, and that process is called as what? Emasculation. Okay, now let's see the next point. What is given? The pollen of male plants are dusted on stigma of emasculated flower. Okay, so see, for the developing of the fruit it is necessary, for the pollination process is very necessary. Here what we are doing? Here we are trying to stop the self-pollination. Okay, then how the pollination will happen? On the next step what we are doing? On the stigma of the emasculated flower we are dusting the pollen grain of male plant. Okay, so the pollen of male plant are dusted on stigma of emasculated flower. Okay, so the pollen grains of the male plant are dusted on the stigma of emasculated flower. After that what happened? Once this process is getting over, then there is what? Pollination process is getting done. After pollination, male and female gametes are get fused. Okay, after pollination the male and the female gametes are fused and they produce the new variety, and that we are calling as what? Hybrid seed. That new variety is called as what? Hybrid seed. And this hybrid seed contains the characteristics of the both male and female varieties. Okay, or this hybrid seed contains the characteristics of the both the parents. Okay, which we have already selected. Okay, so let's take the one example. So if you want to make the hybrid seed, okay, like that, if you want to take the more crop yield and also you want the variety which is the disease resistant, then how we can do that? So one parent we have to select as a which is having the good disease preventing characteristics, and next parent or the another parent we have to choose, like that, those who will give the more amount of the yield. Okay, so the two parents we have selected here, one is what? Those one is showing the characteristic is what? It is giving the higher amount of the yield, and the another one is having the very good resistance to the disease. So we combine that and at the end we are getting the hybrid seed which is having the good resistance to the disease and also gives the higher yield. Okay, so this is only the technique, that is what? Hybridization. In that what happened? The one plant is selected as a male and another one is selected as a female, and at the end these hybrid seed contain characteristics of the both. Okay, so this process is very important to take the increasing crop yield, that is nothing but what? Hybridization process. Okay, so here about what? Hybridization. Now we will move for the last point from the lesson, that is nothing but what? Food from animals. So as we know, up till now we have discussed about the different agricultural practices. We are telling that the plants are the ultimate source, or the plants are the main source for the food on the earth, okay? Or all the living things are depends on the plant for their food. But like plants, from the animals also we are getting some food atoms, okay? Like that we are getting the chicken, fish, honey, cheese, butter, all these are what? Milk product. And where, from where we are getting the milk? From the cow, buffalo, goat, we are getting the milk. So all these are what? The animal products that we are consuming or we are using, okay? So what is mean by husbandry, animal husbandry, that we will discuss now? The science that deals with breeding, feeding and caring of domestic animals is called animal husbandry, okay? So to get the different products from the animal, we are keeping some pets or some domestic animals with you. But if it is on a large scale, then it is called as what? Animal husbandry, okay? Again, I will repeat it. The science that deals with breeding, feeding and caring of domestic animals is called animal husbandry, okay? So like that, if we will talk about the coastal area, in the people, those who are living in the coastal area, their main food is what? Fish. They are consuming the more amount of the fish, okay? So the production of the fish on a large scale, it is called as what? Pisciculture. So in short, what we can say, from the animals also we are getting the different types of the food atoms, okay? So this is all about today. Up till now we have discussed that different agriculture practices, different processes we have discussed, and here we have finished our lesson. It's time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video. For today, thank you.